Hello everyone, in this video I will solve an ICAP examination question of ENTER 2010 with regards to learning curve. And throughout the course of the video I will assume that you have basic knowledge and basic understanding and all the concepts about learning curve. I will directly move on to solving the past paper question. Let us read the question first. The question is from ENTER 2010 MAC Management Accounting past paper of Module F. Question says Ibrahim Limited manufactures a variety of products. There is a company which manufactures a variety of products. It has launched a new product in November 2010 and has produced 1000 units or 10 lots up to the year ended 30th November 2010. Wherein learning our questions, I will recommend everyone that during solving the question, you must draw a number line or a timeline, actually a timeline about what is stated in question. In this question, the company started its production in November and company's year end is 30th November 2010. And the first line says, sorry, so the second line says that a company actually produced 10 lots or 1000 units during November up to the year ended 30th November 2010. So basically 1000 units, or which is equivalent to 10 lots, were produced during this month. Further, the question says that the variable cost of producing the first lot was as follows. Now, the information given below is for one single lot. It says that material consumed, direct labor and variable overhead expenses were as stated for one single lot or 100 units. Fixed manufacturing overheads have been estimated at rupees 1.3 million per annum. Based on past experience, the company expects 90% learning curve ratio to apply on each production lot size of 100 units. Now, the point to remember is that the learning is in lots. There is a difference if the learning is in units and if the learning is in lots. You must realize that over here in this question, the learning is in lots. And by that, I want to say that I am assuming that you have basic understanding of learning curve and you are familiar with this formula. This formula says that A is the hours consumed for first unit. But if the learning is in lots, A will be the hours consumed for the first lot. Okay. Then X is generally the number of units. But if the learning is in lots, X will be the number of lots. And B is log LR divided by log 2. Now, if you are provided with B in your question, you must use that. If you are not provided with B, you must calculate B from this equation log LR or log learning rate divided by log 2. In this question, if you see the last line, the requirement, extremely last line, it is given that B is equals to log 0.9 over log 2 is equals to negative 0.152. If you are provided in exam with B's value, you must use this value in your computations and not calculate it. Examiner wants to use this value in your answer sheets. He wants to see constant answers throughout all examination sheets, and therefore he wants you to use this specific value. So please use this value instead of calculating it. Now, if you calculate y is the average cumulative time. Okay, moving on. I have discussed something about the rates and the equation, which is a basic equation. I am assuming that you know this equation before viewing this video for solving the question. The question further states that the learning curve effect is expected to prevail up to 500 lots. Now, the learning curve impact is for 500 lots. Learning stops at 500 lots, and after 500 lots, there will be no learning. The expected demand of the product for the next year at two different price levels is as follows. Number one, if I charge a price of rupees 650, which is selling price, I will be able to sell 45,000 units, whereas if I charge a lower price, 550, I will be able to sell higher number of units, which is basic principles of economics, that is 70,000 units. Determine which of the price the company should charge for the next year ending 30th November 2011. So the question is straightforward. If I am doing a business, my core purpose would be to maximize my profits. If I am able to earn higher at 650 rupees price per unit, I will sell at that price. But if I am able to earn more, if I sell units at 550, I will be selling units at that price. Now to compute, to actually make a decision, what should I charge my price? What should be my selling price? Either 650 or 550, I will make two profit and loss accounts. One for 45,000 units, at which I will be able to charge 650, and another at 70,000 units, at which I will be able to charge 550 rupees. The P&L with higher profit will be selected. Let us first solve it for option number one, which is selling 45,000 units. Now my relevant year will start over here, since this is 1st of December, and my year will end here, which is 30th November. It is very crucial that you draw a timeline while solving learning curve question. And the question says that you will sell 45,000 units during this time period. So 45,000 units is equivalent to 450 lots. Now let me clearly draw a number line again. I have sold 10 lots before 1st December 2010. I will sell further 450 lots during the year which ends at 30th November 2011. In total, I will be selling 460 lots till this date. 10 which were sold in previous year and 450 which were sold in this year. So let us now do some labor computations or labor workings. We know that y is equals to ax power b, where y is average or cumulative average time per unit. If I have to calculate the costs for the year and profits for the year 1st December 2010 to 30th November 2010, my relevant lots will be 11th lot to 460th lot. Basically, these are 450 lot, but this is not the very first lot. I am assuming that you know why I have selected this. I will be uploading a basic concepts video for this chapter very soon, which will clarify why I took this, why I did not take 450 lots directly. So to calculate the cost of 11th to 460th lot, what procedure I will apply is that I will calculate the total cost for 460 lots, or let's say I will calculate the total time for 460 lots and subtract the cost of first 10 lots, which will leave me with the cost of 450 lots, which are 11th to 460th lot. Now how do I do that? Generally, when I use y is equals to ax power b, a is the hours of the first lot. However, I discussed a case in class in which I said that sometimes you may be provided with the cost of first lot or cost of first unit. In that case, your a would be the cost amount. Now if we see the question, we are not provided with the hours of the first lot. However, we know that the direct labor cost for the first lot was 20,000. So since y gives us, or y is equal to ax power b gives us average, we will calculate the cost for 460 lots by a, which is 20,000, or the cost of first lot 460, since we are calculating the cost of 460 lots, power negative 0.152, since this is given in question, and this whole computation will actually give me the average cost for 460 lots. For total cost of 460 lots, I will multiply it by 460. The total cost will be 3,622,836. Now if I compute the cost for first 10 lots, the cost of first lot is 20,000. My x this time will be 10, power negative 0.152 multiplied by 10. If I have to calculate the total cost for 10 lots, it will be 140939. And this is the cost of first 10 lots. If I subtract the cost of first 10 lots from 3622836, which is the 460 lots cost, I will be left behind with 3481897. So this is the cost if I produce 450 lots in second year. Now we can easily compute the all of the profit and loss account amounts. We will first write our sales or sales revenue amount. Our sales would be, the question states that since we are making PNL for 45,000 units demand, I will be selling 45,000 units and each unit will be sold at 650. So 45,000 into 650 is equal to 29.25 million less cost of material. The cost of material for any lot is 30,000 and 45,000 is equivalent to 450 lots. So 450 into 30,000 would be 13.5 million. After that, I will subtract the labor cost that I have computed above, which is 3481897. After that, if I check my question, I have variable overheads, and variable overheads are 25% of direct labor. Therefore, variable overheads would be 3481897 multiplied by 25%. This comes up to 870474. After that, I will subtract my fixed cost, and my fixed cost would be 1.3 million. So my profit, if I sell 45,000 units, would be equivalent to 10097629. This is my profit if I sell 45,000 units. Well, as per the requirements of the question, I was supposed to suggest what should be my selling price. Either it should be 650 or 550. I have computed my profit at 650 selling price, which is around 10.097 million. What I have to do now is to compute profit if I sell units at 550, and if I sell units at 550, it would be 70,000 units. So I will continue this question and working for 70,000 units, which is a bit more complicated, in my next video. So stay tuned, I will be uploading the second part of this Ibrahim Limited Winter 2018 question very shortly. Thank you.